Programming in assembly, part 0. To understand assembly, you must first understand how the program is laid out in memory. Let's start by looking at the text section. The text section is where executable instructions are stored. This is the section you probably think of when you think of programming. This is where data is manipulated and used to achieve a certain goal. The next section is the data section. The data section is where you store values that your program will use. For example, in a Hello World program, the Hello World string is stored in the data section and is printed to the console in the text section. Similar to the data section, next is the BSS section. The BSS section also stores values that the program will use. The difference is that the values are uninitialized. For example, user input can be stored in the BSS section, but the value that will be stored is not known until the program is run. The last two sections we will look at are the stack and the heap. The size of the stack and the heap change dynamically throughout the program's runtime, storing various values. The stack is organized because it is first in, last out, meaning it acts like a stack of plates, allowing you to add things on top and remove things from the top. But values cannot be added or removed in the middle of the stack. This organization is both quick and limiting. The heap, on the other hand, is unorganized. Values can be removed from anywhere in the heap, and future values can fill in the gaps created from these removals. The benefit of this is that dynamically sized lists, or lists of values whose size grows throughout the program's execution, can be created in the heap. One implementation is that when a dynamically sized list reaches its capacity, each value is copied to an area in the heap with a larger capacity, and the old values are deleted, leaving room for future values.